Vance?
Yes, sir.
Can't you help me on this excise tax thing? You're going to wreck this damn bill. We're not going to have any. And they're going to get together this afternoon and try to make a motion to keep all excise taxes in there. And we need your help.
Well, I voted that way.
I know it. And Clint Anderson, though, they all got mad yesterday because y'all screwed up that oil vote. And they're after the oil companies and Williams and everything else. And those big oil companies oughtn't to be raising hell $40 million. They got off at $400 million, and they ought to let y'all off the hook. But now we've got it in a big screwed up mess, and we all of us going down defeat if we can't operate any better than that. And there's no leadership in the committee. So for God's sakes, get in there. Clint Anderson says he'll change, and you change, and get two or three more, and let's...
The one big thing in there, one thing I wanted was musical instruments.
Oh, well, what's important is the big credit to the Democratic Party, and let's go on. A goddamn band of musical instruments, they won't be talking about it next November.
Well,
what they're going to be judging us by is they're going to be judging us whether we can pass a tax bill or not, and whether we've got prosperity. And if we haven't, we're going to... Every day it costs us $30 million in our economy. So get in there and try to help me on this thing.
Okay, can I save one vote out of there?
Well, we want to just have a general vote. One vote to put all the excises back. That's the way we can get the majority of people out of the bill.
Yeah. Well, let me try to get that done.
You do that and get a hold of Clint Anderson, and you all go together and see if you can't do that for me.
All right.
I'll do something for you.
I know you will.
Goodbye.
All right, fine.
I'll do it.
Hey,
can't you go with us on this excise thing and let us get a bill? God damn it, you need to vote with me once in a while, just one time.
Well, look, I made a commitment, Mr. President. Let me say this. The Treasury Department is reaping the whirlwind.
I know it. But we were ready to report this bill, and now we've got it just good and screwed up, and the Democrats are going to be a miserable failure in the eyes of the whole country. Now, why can't you all meet at 2 o'clock and let's leave this excise like we had it before you met this morning?
Well, I don't know how you're going to get it. The thing was overwhelming.
No, it's not. No. Clint Anderson's going to help us, and Hartke will help us, and if you'll help us, we'll have it over. And I'll appreciate it, and I'll remember it. And help me one way or the other.
Well, you know, just one word, Mr.
You've had these problems, executive, and you know we've had that damn bill there since September, and every day it's costing us $30 million in consumer income, every single day.
Well, one of my problems is one of the amendments in there is for something in my own home state that's already been...
I know it, but every one of them have got it in there, my friend, but God Almighty... I think about the problems I've had, and when you want to go on that committee, I just stood up and said, by God, it's going to be. Now, I just want one vote, and I want to get that bill out of there, and I got to have it, Abe. And you've had problems. You've been an executive, and you can find a way to help me. They've asked me to call you 40 times this year, and I've never done it. But this time, when it means $400 or $500 million, this is going to be a whole motion to leave all the excises as they were before Williams and them got mad on the oil thing. And don't let John Williams and Barry and Everett Dirksen screw me this way.
Well, it isn't, Mr. President. I wish you had called me. I had talked to President Kennedy before he died about what I looked at the troubles in the Finance Committee. And then he said to me, he said, Abe, he said, look, once we get this up there, I will call all the Democrats together and try to work it out. Now, the Treasury, the great tragedy to me, Mr. President, and I want to be very frank with you, is that Dylan doesn't know the politics and the...
I think that's right, and he's sick. He's sick, and I don't know him either, but I want you to know him this afternoon and go in there and either don't vote one way or the other, but let them put these damn things back and vote with us if you will. And we can't lose $400 or $500 million revenue in this thing.
Well, let me see how I can save my face. I got a problem.
Don't you worry about saving your face. Your face is damn good shape, and it's going to be better when I get with you. I'll save your face.
Yeah,
you just,
Mr. President,
you save my face this afternoon, and I'll save your face tomorrow.
Well, sometime I would really like to talk.
You
with
can
you.
Do it any hour. I've had 56 days in this job, and they've been the most miserable 56 I've ever had.
You're
my people are going opposite directions, and that damn Harry Bird goes one way, and he says, cut your damn budget, and I'll help you get your bill out. He called me yesterday and said it'll be reported tomorrow. I thought it was all settled.
You're doing great, Mr. President. Honestly,
welcome.
You're doing so great, it isn't even...
Will you go in there and help me this afternoon?
Let me see how I can work it out.
Well, you just work it out. Now, don't say how. I don't give a damn about the details. I just want you to work it out, will you?
I'll do my...
All right.
Okay, Mr.
Bye.
President.
Bye.